Hey, it's Mark from supplyhouse.com, and in this video, we're gonna talk about connecting PEX tubing to copper pipe. We will be using all half-inch pipe pieces as examples. The fastest and easiest way to connect PEX directly to copper pipe is by using SharkBite connections. These connections require no tools and no soldering. If you aren't using SharkBite connections, you will need a copper pipe adapter, also known as a female sweat adapter. The copper side will slide right over the copper pipe to be soldered. You should do the soldering first to avoid any risk of damaging your PEX tubing. You then connect your PEX tubing to the other side using one of the PEX connection options. If you are connecting PEX to an existing fitting, you will need to use a copper fitting adapter, also known as a male sweat adapter. This may be the case if your copper pipe is connected to an elbow or other type of fitting, and you don't want to cut your pipe. The copper side will slide right into the existing fitting to be soldered. You then connect your PEX tubing to the other side using a PEX connection. The main thing to remember is the difference between copper pipe adapters and copper fitting adapters. Copper pipe adapters slide over copper pipe, while copper fitting adapters slide into existing fittings already on your pipes. If you are connecting PEX to something with national pipe thread, we also have male and female threaded adapters. National pipe thread is a generic thread you can get at any store. You simply screw on the threaded end, and the PEX end will be connected using a PEX connection. Fittings are named based on the size of the pipe they work with. Copper pipe sizing refers to the inner diameter of the pipe. For example, a half-inch pipe adapter doesn't actually measure half-inch. It simply fits over the half-inch copper pipe. For more information about PEX to copper fittings and adapters, visit supplyhouse.com or email us with any questions.